if not now, when, is kind of a question I've always, it's like in my blood, it's a question I've been asking since I was a little kid. My parents will tell you stories of how I organized a toy drive at the age of, I think, like 7 at my elementary school in first grade. If not now, when, in terms of like going and feeding the hungry and feeding the poor and volunteering in our communities, but then when it comes to looking at our own privilege and our own wealth, there's like this block and this scarcity and this feeling of like, I'll give it away when I'm older. And it's not really in the sentiment of if not now, when. It's like, it's more like, I don't know, like if not now, you know, can wait until I'm 90 years old or to the next generation.
There's no better time to redistribute the resources I have access to than right now. And I think, you know, I see injustice, I mean, on a daily basis, it's like everywhere. And so I think, yeah, that a big piece of it is seeing that and knowing that I have access to something that I actually changed that. And that I think asking myself, like, why wait until
a few years back started a collective called the Hummingbird Collective. And we pooled our resources and fundraised our families and our communities to fund migrant justice organizing in Arizona. And I think we'll have moved almost $500,000 by the end of 2014. And so, you know, on our end, it's a lot of like fundraising and talking about money and trying to get people to give money. And it's kind of hard to like picture what that feels like on the ground. And then this past 2 weeks ago, I got to travel back down to Arizona and see the impact that's had on communities down there. And these are communities where people on a daily basis our families are basically being destroyed through the immigration system, and people are being deported and businesses are being raided, and you know, children are growing up without one of the parents in the household. And just to go down there and see the impact that the money we had raised had on the communities down there, and how it's supported both like people getting out of deportation and getting to come back with their families, and it's how it's supported community building and people really building power from the ground up, has been super. Yeah, I think I grew up and got involved in social justice work with this mentality of like working 60 hours a week and just like giving everything for the movement, and like that's what it meant to be a good activist and a good organizer. And recently in the last few years, I've just been unwinding that, unpacking that, and realizing that in order to do the work I want to do in the world, that actually it's about like my healing and my process, and that like feeling myself first, and that's going to make me more effective in the world. With my work in resource generation, I work with a lot of young people with access to wealth who are answering a lot of the same questions, and often we talk about like how much is enough is like a big question, and that's kind of been my advice the last year or two, is like, you know, somebody once told me like, what's the most you want to give, and then, you know, give a little bit more. And so I think I've taken that as like, give the level where you feel a little bit uncomfortable and where it feels a little bit scary. And my Jewish identity and is so tied into my justice work, and how reclaiming that is really so crucial in me pushing back against injustice, pushing back against racism and the way that assimilation has caused us to lose a lot of our culture. I feel like so grateful for this place and for finding Adamah and for finding Friedman. I think it's really, at its core, it's really grounded me and myself and in my traditions and my practices. I think you know, I look at my life like pre-Friedman and post-Friedman feels like two different, very different parts of my life. I'm feeling work in this internal work, but that can only go so far, right? And then I need to be thinking about what is my specific place in the world, both, you know, as a Jewish person, as a queer person, as a woman, and also a person like a white person, a person with access to class privilege, and a citizen of this country. Like, what is my role, and how can I really strategically use that unique role to make the greatest impact? And I think Thank you.